Will health. Health, it's so important. I used to think that time was the most precious commodity, but then I came to realize that actually energy is the most precious commodity that we have. Because it doesn't matter what a grand vision you have and how creative you are and how hardworking you are. If you don't have energy, how far are you gonna get? I usually say, think of Lamborghini. Such a sophisticated car. It can go so fast and so far, and yet if you don't fill it up, if you don't service it, if you don't actually keep it in the right condition, how far is it gonna go? How much are you gonna squeeze out of it? So health is incredibly important, and the two main things that a person should look into if they want to improve their health, I believe, is sleep, so to improve the quality of their sleep, and also to eat slower. So with the quality of sleep, there are a lot of articles and a lot of people talking about how many hours do we need to sleep. And it varies. It's actually a very interesting topic, and it varies because Napoleon slept 4 hours and Einstein slept 12. I have a friend who sleeps once in 2 days only for 6 hours, and that's it. That's what works for him. When it comes to actually sleeping for 4 hours, only 1 or 2% of the population can recharge within that period of time. Most of us on average need between 8 to 10 hours. But the quality of sleep is even more important. So once again, so many articles about morning routines when you're priming yourself for the day to come to be more productive, but barely anyone is talking about evening routines. And evening routines are as important because you're preparing yourself to sleep. Like, we don't wake up and we don't fall asleep, you know, like this. Our body needs to prepare us to either be alert or to doze off. So at least for an hour before going to bed, don't use any electronic devices. Try to read a book or go for a walk. And 2 hours before going to sleep, finish your dinner. So don't eat later than that. So there are a lot of things that you can do to prepare yourself and get better sleep within actually less time. And I think everyone agrees with me that sleep is the most important thing for our health. But the second most important thing is nutrition. And I was very interested to find out that actually we're only 10% human and 90% we're microbiome. So we have a lot of bacteria, viruses, fungi, even single cell organisms living in our body or on our body. And in particular, the most important community is our gut bacteria. So one of the mistakes I was doing most of my life is that I was eating very quickly and maybe only once a day, and I always was annoyed that I actually had to do it. I saw it as something that I had to do, not that I wanted to do. Thing is that our gut bacteria is very sensitive and reacts to our state of our mind. So if we are stressing out about something or eating quickly something, our gut bacteria thinks that that food is not good for us, that we're actually stressing out about the food. And as a result, it gets less nutrition, maybe even more calories out of it. But if you're eating mindfully, if you actually focus on what you're eating and you enjoy it, then your gut bacteria, no matter how bad that food is, even if it's like a McDonald's burger, but you're on a beach, you know, surrounded by your friends and you have good laughs and you're relaxed, your gut bacteria will extract all the nutrition it can out of it and will make it as beneficial as possible for you. So this is why actually one of the reasons why a lot of people pray before having a meal, because they slow themselves down and they express gratitude and they become mindful about enjoying that meal. So yeah, better sleep and eating slower are the first two things that someone should look into when they're trying to improve their health.